Assalamu alaikum students, welcome to another session in topology. In the last lecture, we defined the interior point in interior of a set. Okay, we studied that if we have a metric space and we have any subset of that metric space, then any point belonging to that subset will be an interior point if we draw an open sphere around that point, taking center at that point, and if that sphere belongs to that set. Okay, we discussed and we illustrated this concept with taking examples of various metric spaces. So for example, if we consider the metric space X, which is our usual metric space R, so on the real number line, so if we consider any point, suppose A, and if we draw a sphere around that point, taking A as center, sphere of any radius R, then that sphere of radius R centered at A will be a subset of the set of real numbers. So that sphere will lie in the set of real numbers. So we will say that this point A is an interior point of this, the set of real numbers. So if we consider the metric space R and set A as the set of natural numbers, we studied that the set of natural numbers has no interior points, because if we draw an open sphere around a natural number, then that open sphere has some points which are not natural numbers. So that open sphere does not belong to the set of natural numbers. So the set of natural numbers doesn't have any interior points. Similarly, the set of integers and the set of rational numbers don't have any interior points. But the set of real numbers does have interior points. Every point of the set of real numbers is an interior point. Similarly, if we consider our metric space X, again R, and A be any open interval A to B, which is a subset of R, and it is the set of all real numbers between A and B, then every point of this interval is an interior point. Okay, so now today we have another definition which is directly related to the interior point of a set, and that is the neighborhood. So here we say that A is an interior point of this set A. Okay, so here A is an interior point of A. So we can also say it another way, that the set A is a neighborhood of A. That is, A is a neighborhood of small a. Okay, so this is our discussion for today. So let us define the neighborhood of a point in a metric space. So let XD be a metric space and A be a subset of any subset of X, then for some element A belonging to the set A, A is called a neighborhood of small a if an open sphere centered at A is contained in the set A. So again, you can see that this is the definition of interior point of a set. Okay, so A is an interior point of A is the same as A, capital A, the set capital A is a neighborhood of its point. So we can also describe this definition as the set A is a neighborhood of small a if and only if a is an interior point of capital A. Okay, so we can also write this thing. So this is a biconditional sentence, that is, if the set A is a neighborhood of A, then A will be an interior point of A. Similarly, if A small a is an interior point of capital A, then capital A will be a neighborhood of small a. So now let us illustrate this with some examples. So let us consider our matrix space X as the usual matrix space, which is the set of all real numbers. Okay, now let us consider its subset A be the set of natural numbers. Okay, since the set of natural numbers doesn't have any interior point, because for the set of natural numbers, if we have a natural number A and if we draw any open sphere around it, then that open sphere doesn't belong to the set of natural numbers. It has some points which are not natural numbers. So it means the set of natural numbers doesn't have any interior points. It means the set of natural numbers cannot be the neighborhood of any of its points. Okay, so N, which is the set of natural numbers, is not a neighborhood of any point. Similarly, the set of integers is also not a neighborhood of some point. And also the same thing happens for the set of rational numbers. But for real numbers, since every real number is an interior point of the set of real numbers, so every real number is an interior point and the set of real number is the neighborhood of every real number. So again, for z, so z is equal to the set of integers is the same thing. It is not a neighborhood of any of its points. The same thing holds for the set of rational numbers. It is not a neighborhood of any of its points. But R is the neighborhood of every real number. So the set of real numbers is the neighborhood of every real number. And similarly, if we consider any subset of the set of real numbers in open interval, so like this, if again our matrix space is R and let set A be this open interval. Now, since every point of this open interval is an interior point, okay, so this open interval will be the neighborhood of each of its point. So here, this A is a neighborhood of each of its elements. Okay, so we saw that if a point is an interior point of a set, then that set is also a neighborhood of that point. So if some number A is an interior point of a set A, then set A will be a neighborhood of that point A.